design of shear machine lever. The statement is, a manually operated shear machine as shown in the figure is used to cut maximum 6 mm diameter of steel bar. SUS is 350 megapascal. The links, lever and pins are made up of steel with SYT as 250 megapascal. Design pins at D, E and G, lever and links AB and DG. Using factor of safety of 5, the length to diameter of pin is 1.2 and allowable bearing pressure is 10 megapascal. So this is the problem, and machine is shown here. We apply force either manually or pneumatically or hydraulically at point H. So lever EH is to be designed, EGH. Link, this link, push it down, and then this bar is cut in two pieces. So no doubt, this bar will be in a single shear, and this will be cut into pieces if only if the shear force is greater than its shearing resistance through the area. So this is a single shear case. Design stress, for calculating this, design stress is given as SYT by N, factor of safety, and shear stress, design stress is, we can assume half of this using on the basis of maximum shear stress theory, is 25 megapascal. So no doubt, as we have to design pins and lever and links, we have to find out what is the amount of force at each pin and in links and lever, and then to we have to identify what is the effect of that load. We have to find out the reactions at pin for designing pin, the resultant of reaction at point D, G and E will be the load on pin D, G and E, and this force F is also to be obtained. So we can find out all these by force analysis as usual, and force for calculating reactions or unknown force, we use free body diagram for the analysis. So let us start with free body diagram. Free body diagram of link GD. Let me quickly revise how to draw free body diagram. We have to reproduce the link GD, and then we have to replace the supports with appropriate reactions. Here this link GD is supported through pin joint at point G and D. So we have to apply two force reactions at those two points. So first step, reproduce this link. Second step, show reactions at the support, and then third step is to apply external force, but here this link is not subjected to any external force. So this is the free body diagram of link GD. Similarly, free body diagram of link EH is reproduce this link as it is, and then apply reactions at point E. It was pin support, so that is why the two reactions are there. At point G, it was also pin support, so two reactions. Here it is important to note that when any point is appearing at first time on any link, then we can mark any arbitrary direction. So here, that is why here GX and GY, they are taken in this fashion without any, you can say, pre-assumptions. And here also at point D, it is not necessary to mark this GX and DX in opposite direction, but you can mark, because it is our basic principle that whenever any point is appearing first time, you can mark any direction. So we can mark any direction here, we can mark any direction here at point G and D, but when any point is appearing a second time, or the same point is appearing on the other link, then certainly we have to make use of Newton's third law to balance to keep this particular point in static equilibrium, and the resultant force acting at point G should be zero. Here Gx and this Gx, if some of these two will be zero and some of these two will also be zero. So whenever any point is appearing, the same point is appearing on the other link, then we have to keep the direction opposite to whatever is assumed when it was appearing first time. So this concept we'll be using. And this, the third step is to apply forces, external force. So here in this case, force F is acting. Now let us draw link BD. The same concept will be used. B is appearing first time, so that is why you can mark any direction. D is already there, so we have to make show the equal and opposite forces. And then CY is the force that bar is applying on this link BD. And then link AB, this B point, it was already there, so that is why it is equal and opposite here. So this guy is complete free body diagram. Now if we analyze this, there are so many unknown forces, and we know that each free body diagram represents that this particular member is in static equilibrium under the action of the applied forces and the reactions. Let me clarify this. This is not free body diagram of link AB, that is why it is marked only at link AB. And all three links, they are free body diagram, because here we have not removed support. So in this diagram, we are simply representing forces on this link AB. So it means that all these three members are in static equilibrium under the action of the forces and reactions. So each of three will be satisfying a set of static equilibrium equations separately. So, but as the unknowns are more, so that is why let us try to find out if we can eliminate some of the unknown reactions or forces. And for that, we can focus our attention on this member. This member is a member which is subjected to forces at two points, at point D and G. So these such type of members are called as two force member. So two force member, basic definition, we have already studied while we have studied the trusses, where every member is a two force member, and we analyze that two force member is subjected to number of forces at two points only. We can have two forces here, we can have any number of force, n number of forces here, n number of forces here. But the property of this type of member is that resultant of force at one point and the resultant of forces at second point, they will be equal, opposite and collinear, and then only the member will be in static equilibrium. So that is why the members that we have studied in trusses are axial member, because that collinear force will act along the axis of the member. So it means, if the force on this is only along the axis of the member, it means that Gx and Dx, they will zero, they will not be there. So if Dx is not there, then this, it means that this Dx will also disappear. And it means that because there is no reaction at point D in horizontal direction, so that is why Bx will also be zero. So here this member Bx will also be zero. And as Gx is 0, so here there is no other force than Gx and Dx, Gx and Ex. So that is why if Gx is 0, Ex will also be equal to 0. So now we can remove these reactions which are 0, and we can get the free body diagram like this. So here we have removed the Dx from here, Bx from here, Bx from here, Ex and Gx from here. So now we are left with a slightly lesser number of unknowns which can be obtained using simple equations of static equilibrium that can be applied each and every free body diagram separately. So now let us find out first what is the value of Cy. So Cy is given by the shear strength in shear strength of the bar, and then ultimate strength and shear, and then this surface area, the cross section area, not surface area, the cross section area of the member to give the maximum load at which the bar will shear. So ultimate strength in shear multiplied by cross section area will give us the load at point C as 9897 newton. So this, as Cy is known to us, then only we can find out By and Dy, and then we can proceed for calculating other reactions. So Cy here 9897. Now we can apply equations of static equilibrium for the link BD. The summation of all the forces about point B should be equal to 0. This gives us dy is equal to minus 3299. It means dy will act downward, but we have assumed upward, so we will be using minus 3299 newton. Likewise, we can get By. Similarly, dy, whatever is obtained, we have the dy here, and By here, By here. We can now make use of this equation summations Fy0, because there is no force along x direction, so summation Fx0 is not of any use. Summation M is equal to 0 will not be of any use, as the both the forces are passing through both the points of application of force. So Gy is minus 3299. Now we can focus our attention on link EH. In this case, the equation of equilibrium, moment equation of equilibrium, that summation of all the forces, summation of moment of all the forces about point E is 0. This will give us F as 329.9 newton. Summation Fy is equal to 0 will give us Ey as 2969.1 newton. So now if we see what is the effect of this load. This load is axial load, so this axial load will induce axial elongation, and that will result in direct tensile stresses. So if we have to design this member, our design equation will be induced stress is equal to design stress. Here induced stress is direct tensile stresses, so it is force divided by area, that is equal to sigma d design stress. So this will give us value of diameter of this link DG is 13 mm. Now this load is a transverse load, so it will induce bending. Effect of load is bending, and the direct stresses due to bending will be induced. So design equation is induced stress is equal to design stress. Induced stress here we will obtain by bending expression, and maximum bending moment is at this fixed end, so that is why this will give us value of diameter of this link as 60 mm. And this free body diagram of link EH shows that this lever is again under transverse load, to be subjected to bending, and the stresses will be due to bending. To design this, we can make use of bending moment diagram. Maximum bending moment is 296910 newton mm. So maximum induced stress is equal to design stress, that is general design equation. Maximum induced stress we get from bending formula. So bending equation will give us this value of Z required, and maximum value of Z should be 5938.8 mm³. So any section which is having lower than this value will not sustain this loading. If we assume H is equal to 2B, we will get B is equal to 20 mm, H is equal to 44 mm, and Z required is 5938.8 mm³. Let us now start designing a pin where load is maximum. So this is the pin where load is maximum. We can assume this is a overlapping type of arrangement, and this is the assumed loading, and this is how we can model it, that this is fixed in one link and then FP is acting. This LP by LP is this length in one lever, and this is length in another lever of pin. So here if FP we assume half of this, so and we assume that this is supported at half of this, so this value is LP. So from here we can find out bending moment and we can calculate this relation. We can obtain this relation by assuming if its pin is solid and it is equally strong in bending and bearing. So we get this LP over DP as 0.313 under root sigma d over PB. We have already derived this expression for a pin which is supported at fulcrum or at a joint, like just like a fork type of arrangement. In that case, the loading is different and the arrangement is different. So at this model is for overlapping type of arrangement. Here it is lever number one, here it is link number two. So now we can have this type of loading. It means whenever we are using LP over DP expression or relation, it means we have fixed the type of arrangement of the fulcrum pin, whether it is fork type or overlapping link type, and the type of loading, and thirdly that we are assuming the pin is equally strong in bending and bearing. Let me again repeat it. We can otherwise design the same pin by bending consideration, by bearing consideration, and by shearing consideration. The largest of the value of diameter of pin will be our final answer in that case. But otherwise, the better way is to design a pin which is equally strong in bending and bearing. So that is why we make use of such type of relation. Otherwise, we have other options as well for designing this. So if we use this, we find that this DP is 22 mm and LP is 16 mm. So we can check this in shear. In general, as we have already discussed, that the shearing is not at all required to be discussed, to be checked, because it is very less, unless until it is a hollow pin. So that is why this pin is safe in shearing mode of failure. Now this is what we have obtained. Let us try to design the section at pinhole, because if we want to accommodate this pin here, we have to make a hole and then the section is modified and the value of Z is reduced, and we have to make it sure that section of lever should not be, the section modulus of lever should not be less than required at any section. So in this case, LP is less than B, so we will increase the length of pin to fit into lever, and it means that we will be modifying this lever section by increasing the height of the lever rather than providing boss. Boss we provide when LP is greater than B, and to accommodate that pin in lever, we provide boss. So here in this case, when LP is less than B, we try to increase value of height of this. So in this case, H for this particular section is given by this expression. This should be equal to the Z required, which is 5938.8. We can find out the value of H dash. We can take H dash as 46 mm, and we can also reduce slightly the height of this lever at this pin even, because here at moment is zero. So that is why this is our general practice. On the larger side, we can have half. If this is 46 mm, let it be 23 mm. 23 mm is the diameter of pin hole as such. So thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe, share and like if you liked it, and visit engineeringinfo.in to download notes in .pdf form. Thank you.